All right, what's up everyone? We're back and we've got something a little bit different planned for this one. Now, as you can see, I've got two absolutely massive boxes here in front of me. This stuff was sent in to me by Jason. Now, Jason was doing a sort of a house clearance, had all this stuff sitting around, had absolutely no use for it, and just wanted to send it into the channel. So we'll talk about it again later on, but just thanks so much, mate. Can't wait to get stuck into this. Now, I've kind of got a rough idea what's in here, but this is still a complete mystery to me, as I've taken most of the tape off and just sort of retaped the top of it, just so I wouldn't be tempted to go through it. I've literally been sitting on this stuff for over a week waiting until I have a few hours to sit down and unbox it, so we'll see how it goes. As I said, this is probably going to be a fairly raw video. I have my phone here, so we'll do some sort of little snippets of what we're looking at as we go along. No idea how long it's going to be, no idea how long it's going to take me to go through these two boxes. We might even have to split it into two parts if it's going on a bit long, but one thing I don't want to do is just plow through it and rush it. I really want to do these boxes justice, but just make sure and stay tuned for this one. These are boxes rammed full of like games, consoles, old retro stuff. It's just going to be so much fun to go through, and I can't wait to see everything that's in here and share it with everyone. So yeah, we'll get stuck in now. As I said, it's probably going to be a bit of a raw video. I don't know all of what I can do with editing on this one. We'll probably just kind of jump cut a lot of stuff. You'll have to ignore the angle. This is the best that I could do. The game room up here is rammed full of stuff. As you can see, I've got shit on chairs, on the floor, everywhere. But this was the best way I could figure it out to kind of sit down, get everything open, get it all laid out. I might actually just move one of these boxes over to the side first, just so as that when we open this up, we have somewhere to put all our few bits, and then we'll start getting stuck into this one here now. So that's a bit better. We've got a bit of space to work right now, so let's get box number one opened up, let's get stuck in, and let's see everything that's in here. Actually, I probably stuck this down better than I thought. I might need to get a feckin' knife or something out. There we go, reef it open. Okay, and there we go. So box number one, what are we seeing straight off the bat? This is actually pretty cool. It's like one of those neon signs. We've got a PlayStation sign, racing pedals, Wii game straight off the bat. We have, oh, look at this. This is absolutely class. There's like literally a boxed Walkman. You'll have to shout out if you had one of these back in the day, but Walkman were life when I was actually, there's two of them. There's another Philips one there. This one is hardcore. This has got the bass booster on it, so you know that that was what it was all about. Let's see. I won't spend too much time on the phone here. I'll have a quick look at what's in here, and then we'll start pulling stuff out as we go along. But yeah, we've got Skylanders. There's a wallet here with God knows what's in here. Oh no way, this is a Discman. Look at, actually, is it a Discman or what is it? I don't know, we'll figure it out as we go along. But yeah, we've got like, this is full of like Skylanders in here. We just move some other stuff around. Like I said, we just have a quick route and then we'll start pulling stuff out. Oh my god, yeah, this is full of Skylanders. I see some PlayStation controllers. I see a mystery controller down there as well. I see some PS1 games in the corner here. Right, I'm gonna start pulling stuff out of this box here, just start getting stuff laid out and try and get into the bottom and see everything that's in here. So this PlayStation light is pretty cool. I have like a kind of a standard one there, but I do like the colors on that one. So that's something that we're gonna keep, that's gonna go up on the PlayStation shelf. As I said, as we go through this stuff, I will talk about what I'm gonna do with it. Full disclosure, Jason sent me this stuff for free. He didn't want anything for it. He wouldn't even take anything for postage for it. Yeah, just wanted it to go to someone that would appreciate it, add some stuff to the collection. But what I'm gonna do is that I mentioned earlier on, I think probably box number two has got a few consoles in it. But yeah, anything that's in here that I don't have is going to go into the collection. We're definitely going to give some of this stuff away. As I said, if you sent it to me for free, you know how it works in this channel. People send stuff in, I pay it forward. For anything that comes in, we send stuff back out. So we're going to have a look through here. We'll pick out a few bits at the end and we'll do a nice little giveaway at the end of the video. But yeah, box two over here has a few consoles in it. From what I remember saying to me, I think there might be more than one or two PlayStation 2s in here. We already have a PlayStation 2 here, so what we might do is we might get them cleaned up, tested, and if we can get them all up and running, maybe we'll like sell them off, we'll do some sort of draw or something like that, and we'll put the money together towards the end of the year, we give it to some sort of charity or something like that. But like I said, we'll get into all that at the end. Let's just keep going through these. Michael Jackson The Experience, which comes with a Jedward ticket. I'm not sure if Jason went to Jedward at Leisureland in Galway on their summer tour in 2010, but we'll leave that in there because, you know, anytime we find that and like that, it stays with the game. It's part of the history of the game. But yeah, not a bad disc actually, and it comes fully complete with the manual. Michael Jackson The Experience, I've seen it out and about a lot. Never actually picked it up. I think it was something that was worth a few quid in the States back in the day. I remember some of the lads used to look out for it in their sort of Goodwill hunting videos and stuff like that, but I don't think we actually have that one, so that's probably straight off the bat something that gets added to the collection. So this is... actually, what console is this for? Let's have a look. So this is for the PS2 or PS1. This is like one of these steering wheels. And obviously these are like the pedals and stuff to go with it. So maybe this is, actually no, this would be, I'm not sure if this, actually it says, yeah, PS2 foot pedal. So that's pretty cool. So this hooks into here, this goes into the PS2, and obviously you have like your little racing setup. So, and so this is all stuff that, I don't know if this is something that we'll keep. Maybe we'll bundle this together with a PS2 and we'll do like a little racing bundle or something like that. I'm dicing my death putting this stuff on the ground here, by the way, as well, because at some stage I am going to have to get up and start moving stuff around, but hopefully we don't fall over it. I am not sure what this is. It's some sort of a stand or something like that. Maybe it's got something to do with the, I don't see any brand on that, anything like that. Maybe it's something to do with the foot pedals. I don't know. We'll leave them all together for now. This is another sort of a racing stick. This is kind of like almost like a Formula One type. I'm not really an expert when it comes to any of the racing stuff. As any racing games I play, I just played normally. So if anyone is familiar with all this stuff, it's actually pretty cool. It's got like some buttons on the back and stuff like that. That's the L1 and R1. So it's obviously like another PlayStation thing. Actually feels really nice in the hands. That's pretty cool. And so we'll kind of keep all that sort of stuff together. Yeah, this Walkman. Look at this Philips Walkman. That definitely takes you back. As I said, it's got the bass boost on there, so you know this is like a hardcore one. Actually got a clean battery compartment as well. Actually, this looks pretty much brand new, like it was never even used. All the instructions and all are in there, so that's a nice little piece to have. Actually, I wonder if we can find out what year this was from. This one seems kind of familiar to me. I wouldn't be surprised if this is like early 2000s. I think possibly remember even selling this when I used to work in like the music shop back in the day. I don't know, but that's pretty cool. We might actually get a bit of use out of that. Maybe we'll like throw it on and go for an old school walk one day, throw the overhead headphones on, just go for a little stroll around. But yeah, disc, what I thought is a disc, man. It says dynamic bass boost, dual DAC, bitstream conversion. It just seems a bit chunky to me for Discman, so I don't know whether that's what I'm looking for or not. There's like a model number on there, and it came in this Pullman bag. I don't know whether that's just something that these sort of things came in back in the day. So I don't know if that's any sort of a clue towards what it is, but I don't think there's anything else in here in like the side pockets or anything like that. No, so again, another mystery item for us to figure out later on. I said I don't want to spend too long dwelling on stuff in here. I don't want this video to be about 6 hours long, but again, I don't want to fly through it all either. But here's actually, I undersold this, and this has the bass boost system as well, this Casio Walkman. This is pretty class. I don't think they actually really put years on these boxes. There's no real way of knowing, but oh my god, this still has the foam and the headphones and everything in it. Look at this. This is, actually I have to keep remembering to get like some phone shots, some close-ups. This is absolutely class. This is the setup I'm talking about, where we get these over the head. Probably comes with some sort of an old belt clip as well. Doesn't I wonder, like, this is absolutely clean as well. I don't know if this has ever been used either. But yeah, these are the sort of ones that used to come with like the belt clip, so you could clip it on there and you'd look the business walking down the road with this on. So yeah, we might have to throw it on for the crack. But yeah, we get this back in the box and let's keep going, because you can see we've got a lot to go through in this box here. All right, so just trying to keep pulling some of the bulky stuff out of the way. This is actually pretty cool. I can't see into the battery compartment because it's screw closed, but it's obviously like some sort of a neon light up. We'll have to find a little spot in the game room for that somewhere. Anything else bulky that I can get in here? Yeah, so some of these Skylanders portals. This is obviously for the 360. No, I don't know anything about Skylanders, and there's an awful lot of stuff in here. I've been saying for a while I want to kind of pick a few up just to give myself like a cheap sort of education in them, so it doesn't really get much cheaper than this. But we'll have to lay all these out later on. Maybe we'll do a little couple of sub videos about all this stuff that's in here. Maybe we'll have a look at all these, search them all up and see if anything are worth anything. Might even be able to do a little guide to Skylanders out of all this stuff. So this could be the box that keeps on giving in terms of videos. We have another portal in here. This is another Xbox one. So we'll just keep moving these things around. So get the bulky stuff out of the way. Oh, there's, I said there was PS2s in here. There's a PS2 Slim. It actually looks in pretty nice condition, actually. The vents and stuff like that on the back of it are fairly clean, so that's normally a good sign. Everything that's there, or everything that should be there, is there. And we've even got a little bonus Harry Potter and the Half-Blood Prince in there. So yeah, that's a fairly good sign that that's going to be something that works. Hopefully we have all the leads and stuff like that in here as well, but if not, you know yourself, it's easy enough to grab all these bits and pieces. But yeah, nice little PS2 Slim straight off the bat. We'll leave that down there. This is getting interesting in here now. We have an Xbox Live headset, Halo 2. That'll probably take a few people back. I never actually played any of the Halo games. I think I mentioned before on the channel and got accused of absolute sacrilege, but yeah, still in the packet there, so that's definitely a bit of a throwback for someone. It's not really something that I had. I remember playing like FIFA or Pro Evo or something online. I can't remember. I think I had one of like just the generic grey Xbox headsets. The other one that had like the little piece that came out from the mouth, but still pretty cool to see it in the original box. There's another console here. Let's just get it out of here. We've got a PS1. Now, this is actually a pretty clean PS1 as well. I know it doesn't look at it from the front, but it's just had a sticker residue, like someone had like their own kind of sticker over the front of it there. But again, vents and stuff are fairly clean on this one, so I'd be fairly confident this one would work. So let's just get the phone out and have a quick close-up. Let's see, is there a mystery game in this one? No, no mystery game in that one, but trust me when I say there's plenty of PS1 games in here. Well, sit that over here on top of the PS2. I'm seeing lots of controllers and stuff here as well, actually. So we'll pull all these out, and then I think pretty much what's left in this box, yeah, I'm fairly certain we get all this done in one video. Everything that's left in here looks like it's just a shed load of Skylanders and a lot of PS1 controllers. I'll just do a little close-up look here just to show you all what I'm looking at now. But yeah, so there we go. Controllers buried there. Skylanders, more controllers. Looks like we have all the leads and the hookups and stuff here as well. So yeah, let's keep getting stuck in. Let's keep pulling stuff out. Actually, there's a Wii controller. Yeah, it's not a real one, but let's keep pulling stuff out of here and let's get to the bottom of this box. All right, so that's the generic Wii controller. This is a PS1 with the analog. So yeah, this is a PlayStation analog controller. There's lots of controllers in here. We'll have no shortage of these, lads, by the time we're finished anyway, that's for sure. Let's see. Here's another one. Oh, this is already rolled up. This is another analog controller, which is pretty sweet. Looks like we've got another one. Yeah, three analog controllers. I told you, lads, these boxes are just going to keep on giving. That's what we got. This is... okay, this is just like a generic PS1 or PS2 controller. I'm not too sure. We'll put that down here. We've got another. This isn't an analog. This is just an OG PS1 controller here. Another original PS1 controller. And here we have, actually, this is a PS2 one. Yeah, this is a PS2 controller. So that's pretty cool. I think I have I just got the one PS2 controller? I think I do. So now we have an extra controller here. So if any of my mates come around, I don't really have any mates, but you know, always good to have extra controllers in case someone pops in. Oh, this is class. This is a PS4 one. This nice red PS4 controller. It's Sony branded on the front of it, so I think this is legit. You'll have to forgive my ignorance if I'm getting PS1 and 2 or PS3 and 4 controllers this mixed up. I mean, I have all the consoles, I play them every now and then, but straight off the bat, I'm not sure which is which. Here's an old charger for Black & Decker. I might actually get a use out of that. I have so many tools out in the shed, and I don't know where any of the stuff is out there actually here. We've got a bit of a cable situation here. We'll just sort this out and then we'll continue on. I'll probably cut most of this out. I'm trying not to leave myself with a pile of stuff just sitting around. I'm trying to kind of tidy it up as I go along. Here's another Sony controller. And this is another PS2. This is an official PS2 one. That's pretty nice looking. I see something swinging around or moving around there, so I'm not sure how good a condition this will be in. But like I said, we'll get all these tested out and see how they're getting on. Yeah, PS1 game there. We've got the back of the box for Worms World Party, and we've got a copy of Driver. And we've got NBA Live 2001 as well, so actually these aren't too bad in them, so we'll actually probably pop these into one of our wallets that are sitting around here, because we've slowly built up a few kind of loose games there, so we'll have to get all them organized, try and keep an eye out for like cases and stuff one day. This is another PlayStation controller. I don't want that collapsing on me. More PlayStation controllers. I think it's safe to say we'll be giving away a PlayStation controller at the end of this, but sure, look, what have we got here? HDMI cable. You can never have too many of those. They come in dead handy. This is like one of those old printer cables and stuff like that. I'm just going to put all the cables and things down here if I'm not sure what they are, and we'll sort through them later on. Here's like an RF adapter for something. Oh, actually, that's the Sony PS... there's Sony PlayStation RFU adapter. So this is for the PS1 or the PS2, I think, again. We'll figure it all out later on. This is... oh, I actually got it in the bin. That'll go down. Again, just like sort of USB. Actually, that's a bit frayed as well, so we won't mess around too much with that one. So yeah, just a few more sort of loose cables. Anything else attached to anything? think that's off a 360. What's this one? This is just like Mega TV Drive Challenge. Anyone's ever seen that before, let me know. I don't have a clue what it is. It's very light, so I don't think we'll be doing too much with that one. And yeah, we're pretty much down to just Skylanders now. Never mind. There's a bag of stuff here. So these are all the Skylanders that are in here. I'll do a very quick scan over. If anyone spots anything as I'm going through it, you can let me know. But like I said, we probably won't waste too much time in this video going through all these. Maybe we'll do another little video out of it and just do like a little, as I said, figuring out Skylanders together, or a guide to any of these Skylanders, if they're worth it or not. I know they're ones that have certain kind of plates number ones to look out for, so maybe we'll get all these separated. And yeah, I think we'll put a bit of time into looking at these as its own sort of thing, because we still have this other box to go through here, so. But yeah, let's see what's in this bag here. There's a few other little bits of, like, you know, scarf adapters and stuff like that. So we'll get all those out of here, and then we'll have a look at what's in this bag here. But yeah, I don't know. I'm seeing another PlayStation controller, another joystick, bits and pieces. So yeah, we'll pull this out now. All right, so I'm just gonna move these out of the way for a minute. I'm not sure if you'll be able to see the front of the table here, but it's filthy. I really need to get myself like a proper desk and a proper gaming chair for the room. Just haven't gotten around to it, but it's done the job so far. So yeah, let's see what's in this bag here. We've got another Skylander. Pop him in there. Actually, we've got some Wii instruction books and stuff like that. So we've got the balance board and the Wii Fit. And then we've got something Nintendo DS here. It's a copy of Monopoly. With the manual, just now, like, inner sleeve, whatever, on it. But yeah, look, that's something that we'll keep and add to the collection. We've got, let's just pull these out. We've got another PlayStation 1 analog controller. A nice little pile of them building up over here. PS2 one. We have got a Sony PSP charger. I wonder what that could be for. And yeah, a couple of joysticks. These are sort of old school ones. These are for like the Atari or the Commodore. Do you know what? My Commodore 64, I took down, you know I'm into Commodore 64. We've seen in the game room tour. You see me pick the stuff up at the Irish Gaming Market. We've got a nice collection of Commodore games. And I do have an original Commodore 64. Got it down during COVID. Couldn't really get it working, but didn't put too much effort into it. But one thing I did notice is I couldn't find any joysticks for it. So these are gonna come in dead handy. Yeah, oh, these are like the quick shots. So this is probably actually, do you know what? I can almost remember having this exact joystick back in the day. So that's pretty cool. What else have we got? Another Skylander, pop them into the box there. And then right at the bottom of the bag, I'm sure you can guess it. You've seen the charger for it. We've got ourselves a PSP. So this is a 1000 PSP. Let's see, there's no battery cover for it, but we can get those handy enough. And the battery doesn't look too bad, actually. Normally the batteries are fairly swollen on these and you get absolutely no joy out of them. Obviously we're gonna have to get a cover for that. It's fallen out already. No mystery game in there, unfortunately, but the PSP looks in nice condition. So we probably will end up having to replace the battery, because 99 times out of 100, you have to replace the batteries on these anyway. We'll get ourselves a battery cover. So yeah, maybe it's something we can sell off, as I mentioned. We might kind of take some of the stuff that we already have, maybe sell it off and try and get a few quid together, put it towards a charity or something like that closer to Christmas. But again, that's something that we'll talk about later on. So that's box number one done. Really, really interesting stuff in there. Love seeing all these PlayStation controllers. We've got a PS1, a PS2. We've got two boxed Walkman. We've got a box of Skylanders still to go through. We've got the racing wheel and pedals and stuff set up there. But we'll get stuck into this box number two over here now. This is the one that's got more consoles. There's lots of games in this one. So this is the one everyone's been waiting to see. So give me a minute. Let me get it up on the table. Let me get reorganized here. And then we'll have a look at what's in box number two. All right, so we've got box number two here ready to go. I might have knocked the framing off there a little bit when I was picking this up. I nearly knocked the whole bloody tripod over, but we're gonna get some tape off this. Here we go. Straight into this one now. As I said, this one is just full of games straight off the bat. I can see PlayStation 2. Okay, there's a few PlayStation 2s in here, all right. Some sort of weird retro console that I don't know as well. There's a rake of PS1 games in here too. This is gonna be some box to go through. Let me get the phone out here and give you a little picture in picture of what's going on here. So yeah, this is what we're looking at in the second box. It's a PlayStation's galore over here. This box goes right down as well. There's PS1, PS2 games. We look under here and get these taken out. As you can see, lots of PS2, lots of PS1. Got some DS stuff in here as well. Yeah, there's gonna be some box to go through. Let's get stuck in here now. So I'm just doing a little bit of a rejig here. So I'm kind of just throwing most of the stuff on the floor, but you look, we'll figure it out later on. Move my joysticks down, move my PSP thing. All right, we have a bit of space here to work with. So I'm just gonna pull games out. I'm gonna try and keep them in little piles and stuff on the table, but straight off the bat, Grand Theft Auto San Andreas. It comes with the map and all in there, so that's absolutely crazy. We've got Gran Turismo 3, complete in box. Two games that we have already, so straight away it's looking good for like giveaways, or maybe, as I said, we've got a few PS2s in here, so we might do some bundling up. Like, I can see another GTA game in here straight off the bat. Maybe we'll do like a GTA bundle or something. That's got the manual in there as well. We've got Commandos, Strike Force. Now, as I said, I'll have to go through and see what we have, what we don't have in the collection, but most of these PS2 games we probably do have. We got a copy of Vice City. We have Conflict Vietnam. This is actually complete in here. This actually looks like a really nice condition one. The manual and all is perfect. Yeah, this looks nice in there. We have got Lord of the Rings, The Two Towers. I definitely have all the Lord of the Rings games. That one's complete too. A copy of Tekken 4. Do I have Tekken 4? Let me see. My neck's not really letting me twist around that far. And if I do have it, it's hidden behind the bloody green Power Ranger in there. I can see some sort of Tekken, but yeah, I don't know. This one's probably not in the most amazing condition anyway, but actually this looks okay. And it's got a manual in there just because like, the case was kind of eaten by something. But sure. We have got this one I don't have because I don't recognize the cover of it. Underworld, The Eternal War. This looks in pretty nice condition. Not a bad disc on it. Really nice manual. And shout out to whoever grabbed it because they picked up a copy in the NCBI charity shop for Euros. So we have a copy of Wii Fit Plus. Don't think we'll be doing anything with that one. Oh, this is a class one actually. Rayman 10th Anniversary. Do I have this one actually? I don't think I do. Let me see. In behind the shield there. I actually do have a copy of Rayman 10th Anniversary. So we'll have a look at the discs. Maybe we can upgrade our own copy. Actually, these discs look fine on here as well. Oh, we've got Rayman M and we've got Rayman 3. So we seem to be missing one, but I better double check in my one. I remember getting this. I'm trying to think. Now, this is probably a long time ago. We got this on the channel, but I can't actually remember whether there's a disc that's missing in here or not. I don't know. Anyway, we've got Skylanders, Giants and the 360. We're no stranger to that one. This is a class one, Def Jam Vendetta. We actually have this on the PS2 already as well, so not the best disc in there, unfortunately, either. But like I said, maybe we can get them resurfaced, or Skylander Swap Force. Splinter Cell Double Agent, another one that I think we actually have already as well. And here's one I don't think I have that I've actually been looking for a while, is a copy of Crazy Taxi. Is it in here? It's not in here. Oh, no way. So we've got a case for Crazy Taxi, we've got the manual. Maybe it's in one of these boxes somewhere. There's a lot of stuff going on in here, so you never know. We've got a copy of Crash Team Racing in there. It's actually a PS1 Crash Team Racing in a Crazy Taxi box, but so we'll sort through all these another time. We've got a lot of PS. There's actually some good looking PS1 titles in here, so I think maybe we'll keep the PS1s for closer to the end. There's a lot of PS1 in here, holy sh**. Yeah, let's just keep going through the odds and ends that are in here for us. So, Nintendo DS, we've got Brain Training, that's a whatever one. Rayman Raving Rabbids, we don't actually have this on the DS, so I've mentioned before I really should be picking up more DS games. I kind of just bring them up to CX and trade them in because they're such an easy trade-in. It's just a cartridge in a box. Wreck-It Ralph on the 3DS, is that in there? It is, and there's a nice little bonus in here. Look at this. A copy of Mario Kart 7, so that's a class little bonus game. As I'll have to go through all these cases actually and just see all of what's in here. Meet the Robinsons, I think, was this the last game hunting video? Was it the one before that we actually picked this up loose in Drogheda for like 50 cents? Now we have a case for it, so funny how those things work out sometimes. Pirates of the Caribbean at World's End, so let me just sort these out into a little bit more of a neater stack up the front here. We don't want all this stuff collapsing. We want to make a bit of space in the table here as we pull this stuff out. See a little PS3 bundle here, so let's have a look at these. Alright, so apologies, it's probably a bit of a jump there. As feared, the camera overheated, it was going that long, but we were just about to have a look at this PS3 bundle. We've got Assassin's Creed 3 in here. This has actually got It's got the original receipt, and if you've watched the channel before, if you follow me on Instagram, you know I love just posting random receipts. But this Assassin's Creed 3 was actually, it was brought back because it was defective, would you believe? They had to replace it, but it was bought in the GameStop in Main Street in Castlebar, County Mayo. So there you go. So Assassin's Creed 3 there. Actually, class, we don't have Darksiders, so we've got a copy of Darksiders that we're going to keep for our collection here. No manual, unfortunately, but let's have a look. Pretty nice disc in there. So yeah, we'll be adding that one into the collection. Dead or Alive 5. I possibly have this one already. I'm not too sure. Is this the only Dead or Alive game on the PS3? Because we definitely have one of them anyway. Again, no manual, but that's fine. We won't complain about free games coming with no manuals. And then we've got a copy of NBA 2K14, which is in nice condition as well. So that seems to be, well, God knows what's buried in here, but that seems to be the crux of like the PS2, PS3 stuff. Everything else is in here looks like, well, as I said, there's a lot of PS1 in here, and there's a few sort of consoles as well. So maybe we'll get the consoles out first, and then maybe we'll leave the PS1 games till the end, because there's some class titles in here, and I can't wait to show them to you. But straight off the bat, as I said, there's one kind of retro-y looking console here as well, and this is the Telesport. Now, something about this does seem familiar to me. We had a console years ago before we even had the Commodore 64, and I have memories of having it set up downstairs in the sitting room and playing it. And I always thought it was like an Atari 2600, as this is going right back to when I was like, can barely remember what we had. But something about this console with like the graphics of the things on the front of it and the little switch here for switching between the games is making me think maybe we had something like this. I don't know. We'll have to kind of try and get this set up anyway. This is like an RF, so we'll have to figure something out. I kind of have an old sort of flat screen telly there that takes this cable. Actually, the one here does as well, but kind of going to be a bit awkward trying to get all these sort of set up for testing and stuff like that anyway. So we must maybe keep an eye out for if we get like a small little tester telly that has like, you know, a bit of everything. If it has like the RF cable, has like the RCA connections, the SCART connection, the HDMI, if we can get a little small telly, maybe might set up a little testing station. I've got a shed outside that's full of absolute crap that maybe we could clear out and have like a Studio Mark II or something like that for testing all this stuff up. But I mean, that is pretty cool, even just to clean that up and sit it on the shelf somewhere. Like, that's absolutely class to have open. Knocking stuff out of the Mario shrine. Here's actually one of the controllers for it. I don't really remember the controller though. I think if we had the console, I'd probably remember something about it. I don't know. I definitely think it was a 2600 we had, because I can remember like the little joystick and the one little red button on it. So probably what we had. But there's the controller to go along with this. That's pretty cool. Let's just, again, as I said, get some of the bulky stuff out of here. We move some of these games to the front. And then we have got yet another PS2. This is the Fat Boy. I actually don't have a PS2 Fat. I've only got the Slim here in the collection, which is probably a good thing, because we don't have that much room for consoles. But again, this is a really nice condition PS2. Normally these ones, you can see the fan at the back here, is absolutely spotless. Normally these are caked in like dust and dirt, but this looks like it's in really nice condition. Yeah, the warranty sticker and all is still in place there, so probably a good sign that that would be still working. So again, got my work cut out for me testing all these things. Here's the Nintendo Wii. This is a black Wii. I actually have two Wiis because, you know yourself, if it's a different color, you have to keep it for the collection because we're obsessed. But we already have a black one, so maybe this is another thing that we can test out and move on. But yeah, it's still got like the GameCube controller port in the front of it. Everything is intact here. It's got like a little slow memory card like that. No, we'll have to do a test and see if there's a little bonus disc in here. So I don't know. I think what we'll do is we'll maybe edit this video down when we get it done. We'll call it the massive unboxing. We'll go through it all. If it's not overly long, maybe we'll tack on a little bit of footage at the end of it, maybe just testing some of these consoles out, see if they turn on, see if there's games or something like that in them. Or maybe we'll just do like a little follow-up one in a couple of weeks when we've had time to go through it all, and I'll put that together. So we'll see what we end up doing. But we've got, it looks like we have all the hookups for the Wii. Actually, we've got the power cable, we've got the video cables there, and we've got the sensor bar as well. So that's pretty nice. If that works, that makes that a lot easier to move on, and as I said, hopefully try and raise a few quid out of all this. Another Telesport little controller, so class. We've got two controllers to go with that. We have another PS2, another PS2 Slim, and another clean PS2 Slim as well. This is unbelievable form. Again, no bonus game in that one, but yeah, PS2 Slims, easy to test out as well. And then last but not least, for the consoles, by the look of it, we've got another PS2 Slim. So that gives us what? One, two. Did I have one in the first boxes? I can't even remember how many bleeding consoles are in this box. I think that's 3 PS2 Slims, a fat PS2, a PS1, and a black Nintendo Wii as well. So we've literally got like 6 consoles, 7 if you include the retro thing, so 8 if you include the PSP. So this is absolutely nuts. Jason, I don't know what to say, mate. I know you've been waiting for me to open this up, but this is just class. I've got more games in the back here. I've got more PS3 that I missed out on. Some nice stuff here, some stuff that I don't have for the collection as well. We've got a random 360 wireless controller. It doesn't have the battery pack in the back of it, but funnily enough, when the camera died, I was squeezing my fat arse around here to try and replace it, and I knocked something down on the Xbox shelf, and I went and had a look. It's actually one of the little battery pack covers for a 360 controller. I obviously had one sitting there for ages and forgot all about it, and actually knocked it over, so happy coincidence there. So this is all PS1 stuff, so yeah, we'll leave that till the end, and then let's have a look at this little stack. Actually, we've got a couple of, let's pull the odd ones out here. Got a couple of Xbox One games now. As you know from watching the channel, we don't have an Xbox One. We tend to kind of just take these and trade them in. Maybe we should be keeping them in case we come across an Xbox One at some stage. I know they are getting a hell of a lot cheaper to pick up, so. But yeah, Thief, perfect condition. A game I know nothing about. I'm not sure, is that an exclusive for the Xbox or not? Actually, it's Square Enix, so yeah, maybe that's a good one. We've also got World of Warships Legends. Absolutely no idea. It's the Firepower Deluxe Edition, if that means anything to anyone. Is this just like Battleship, but like spiced up for the Xbox One? I don't know. Disc is perfect in that as well. So if they're worth anything in trade credit, maybe we'll trade them in. See, I don't know. Maybe we'll get a few bits out of this box that we can bring up to CEX and trade in. And maybe we can take the trade credit and maybe buy something for a giveaway. Or I don't know. As I said, it's all just jumbled around up here. I still don't know what we're going to do with half of this stuff. Well, let's have a look. We've got a copy of Call of Duty Ghosts. Motorstorm Pacific Rift. Gran Turismo 5. I think these are all pretty much games that we have already. We'll have a little flick through them. As I said, we might have a few more surprises like that Mario Kart DS from earlier on. Again, probably as well to do like a little follow-up video. We can kind of talk about all this stuff when we've finally had the chance to go through it all. But yeah, this is pretty cool. This is the Call of Duty Modern Warfare Collection. I actually don't have this. This is like a fat steelbook, and we do like a steelbook here. No manuals or anything in there. I'm not sure if they were all supposed to come in there, but we've got Modern Warfare 3, Modern Warfare 2, Modern Warfare 4. I'm not sure if that's all of what was supposed to come in there or not, but yeah, pretty cool little case. We'll probably end up keeping that one. We have a copy of Elder Scrolls 5 Skyrim, a game that we do already have, one that we found a few times in the charity shops. This comes complete with like maps and everything. It's actually got like the fancy clothy map. I know that we have that already. And another receipt. A lot of this stuff was bought in Castlebar. Here's another one from CEX in Castlebar. This was bought there on the 24th of November 2017. So there you go. We have another GTA game, a copy of Grand Theft Auto 4, in pretty nice condition, just some fingerprint smudges, we can clean that up. And then a nice little steelbook to end. This is, what is this called? 20 Arc. People are probably looking at me on this fella's clown, but this is, never heard of this one before. Again, this is another Xbox One. It's got the game and the soundtrack in here. Game is in pretty nice condition. And soundtrack, I can barely get it out, so it's probably never been taken out. Oh, it looks like someone played it. That's good. At least I got some use. But yeah, this is a nice little steelbook here. Again, not sure if this is something that's worth anything. It's definitely missing some sort of a slip or something like that, because there's no barcode on it. But yeah, like I said, we'll do a little follow-up and go through some of these bits and pieces. But that leaves us now with just the PS1. It looks like we've got... Oh my God. There's about 30, 35 PS1 games in here. I can see Metal Gear Solid straight away. I don't have Metal Gear Solid, so we're keeping that. But then we've also got another copy of Metal Gear Solid in here, so hopefully they're both complete. Maybe we can do a nice giveaway with them. But yeah, I'm gonna make a bit of space here, start going through all these games and show you what PS1 stuff is in here. This is gonna be a very fitting finale. There's some class stuff in here. All right, so I'm just gonna keep pulling stuff out until I run out of room. But straight off the bat, let's just have a look at it. A copy of Metal Gear Solid. And this feels heavy, so this feels fairly complete. We've got the Elder Scrolls Oblivion disc in there. It does come with the manual though, so hopefully between this one and the other one that's in there, we can get a complete copy for ourselves. I was kind of hoping to be two complete ones in there, so I could maybe give one of these away. But hang on, what's this bonus disc? Oh, actually, we've got Metal Gear Solid disc 2 of 2. So at least we've got one of the discs. So if disc one is in that other one, we're absolutely laughing, lads. So let's keep that to the side here. Look, there's no point in dragging the arse out of it. Let's pull this other Metal Gear Solid out. This one feels a bit lighter, so let's just pray for disc one. Okay, so this is the platinum version, and we do have the Metal Gear Solid platinum disc in there. So what's in here? Disc 1 and 2 of 2. So we have the two Metal Gear Solid discs for the platinum version, and we've got one disc for the original version. So I'm not sure what we'll do with these. Maybe we'll just keep them banging around the collection. See if we can complete. Well, you know it's going to be a long video when you're apologising for 3 battery swap outs, but hopefully we're okay from now on to the end of the box. But like I was just saying there, yeah, we've got Metal Gear Solid here. We've got the original version of it with the disc 2, missing the disc 1, but we've got a platinum copy here with disc 1 and 2, but no manual. So maybe someone's interested in taking this off us and just sending us out a disc 1 on its own. Or maybe we've got the Game America coming back now in November. So that could be a little mission to add to our little whiteboard that we go looking for a loose copy of disc 1 to try and complete this one. So like I said, the box that keeps on giving, this is probably going to keep us going for months. Or I'm sorry for interrupting, but I'm just jumping in very quick because I've just mentioned the Irish Game America. And it's just to remind everyone that the next event is coming up on the 2nd and 3rd of November. The last video I did from the Game America did so well. There were so many comments from people who had said they didn't know it existed. They wanted to know where it was on, when the next one was on. So this is an ample reminder, and I'll be reminding you in every video between now and then that the next Irish Game America is on Saturday the 2nd and Sunday the 3rd of November in the Royal Marine Hotel in Dunleary. And because so many of you watched that video and reached out in the comments, they've given me an exclusive code so that everyone can get 10% off the cost of the ticket price. All you have to do when you're checking out is enter the code RGI2024, which is magically appearing on the screen here below me, and I'll also put it in the description along with a link of where to go to buy tickets. 10% is 10%. That could be the cost of a game or two on the day, so if you still to buy tickets, why not go in, throw that code in and save yourselves a few quid. Of course I'm going to be there. I can't wait for the weekend. This video has already thrown up loads of stuff that we need to get there. There's going to be loose discs we'll be keeping an eye out for, different cables, different hookups, all sorts of stuff to complete some of the stuff that we've got in this unboxing. But yeah, there's going to be something there for everyone on the day. It's going to be ram-packed with retro games, most importantly of all. So once again, 2nd and 3rd November, mark the date in your calendar, go buy the tickets, use code RGI2024 for 10% off, and I'll see you all there. Oh, and while I'm interrupting, while you're there, just make sure you're subscribed to the channel, because you know, it costs nothing. It really, really helps me out. It really pushes the videos out there. And lately, YouTube's been very kind to me, and it's been pushing my videos out in the algorithm to people that actually enjoy the video. So the more people subscribe, like, and comment, the more it pushes it out there so that other people can find the channel. So if you would take a moment to do that, would very much appreciate it. Anyway, back to this massive unboxing. Piles of PS1 just left here. Actually, see a random DS game in here. So let's take this pile and let's go through it. We've got a copy. Actually, this isn't PS1. This is, I don't know what this is. This is Star Wars Masters of Terras Kasi. Is this like a PC game or something like that? I have no idea. It says teen animated violence. So this is obviously like, oh, SLUS. Maybe this is like a US PS1 game. You'll have to shed some light on that for me, lads. I don't know. You've got a copy of Star Wars Episode 1, The Phantom Menace. Now, I don't have that many PS1 games, so if there is something, I do have a mention. Otherwise, you just assume that this is stuff that's going to get added into the collection, because I, like I said, you can kind of, you won't be able to see them in this shot because I'm pointing down, but if you've seen the game room tour, you know we've got, like, I don't know, maybe 30, 35 PS1 games, maybe about 40 of them up there. But we're pretty much going to double the collection here. This is actually a really nice condition copy of that game as well. We've got FIFA 2000. Shout out to the FIFA Challenge. This is one that will be getting added. As I said, a few people still talk about it this day. Maybe we'll do like a little revisit roundup episode at some stage. Again, shout out to the old charity shop, €1 sticker on there. The Blob 2 on the DS. This doesn't have the Blob in there. It has the manual. It has a brain training cartridge, and it's got a Nintendogs cartridge as well. So if you ever come across an empty Nintendogs case, we complete that. That actually trades in for a few quid. A classics version of Road Rash. Now, Road Rash was class back in the day. I don't know what it's like on the PS1, but just cool seeing all these manuals and stuff like that. And again, this is like in perfect condition as well. So these PS1 games are in really nice nick, which is not something you say very often when you find PS1 games. Plus all the cases have opened so far, actually none of them have fallen apart when they open them up. So we're doing well out of this, lads. Yeah, Soviet Strike. Really nice condition. Have to remember to keep showing these. I'm just so caught up in like looking at all of what's in there. Driver 2, look at this one. This is a disc 2 of 2 as well. Unfortunately, there's no disc 1. So, oh, is there? I know, there's like a little insert there, but no disc 1. But like I said, we'll do a revisit thing. We'll go through all of these in full detail. Maybe there's some missing discs for these in other cases or something. God only knows. A copy of G-Police. Is this like a G-Con game? Is this like a gun game or something like that? I can't remember. This is the first one that's going to, yeah, it's going to come apart as soon as I open it. But both discs are in there for this one. So yeah, copy of G-Police. Something about this is familiar. I think this comes in a big box with like the gun. Nope. You'll have to correct me if I'm wrong, but that's G-Police. Copy of Pro 18 World Tour Golf. Fully complete. I can't believe how many complete PS1 games are in here. This is unbelievable. We've got Tony Hawk's Skateboard and Platinum Box with a disc only copy of Revolt in there. And we've actually got a bonus game in here of Matt Hoffman's Pro BMX. So like I said, there'll be a body of work in this. Definitely going to be another separate video where we sort of consolidate everything that's in here. We have Racing Simulation Monaco Grand Prix. This manual's got a thick boy in there. The disc is in there. And we've even got like a little Lemsip posted in there, or sticky note, whatever we call them here. And it's got like settings for like springs, body, wings, tires there. So someone really took this one seriously. So let's have a little look. We've got the Weakest Link, which was, I don't know what the date is on that, but it was in punts anyway. So it was £29.99 at the time. So yeah, that's an old sticker on that lad. Where else are we? Sticking to the TV show teams. We've got a copy of Who Wants to Be... Oh, Jesus. Yeah, Who Wants to Be a Millionaire? That one's in there. That's another £29.99 game. Actually, this is the Irish edition of Who Wants to Be a Millionaire. So that's actually class. Rest in peace, Gay Bourne. Look at them on the back there. That's actually a nice little piece to have. You know, I mentioned this before with like the Lara Croft magazine that I had, which I ended up giving away because I knew someone that would appreciate it way more than I would. It was just sitting on the shelf over there. We'll find it again another day. But yeah, like I've got a few Irish only editions. That could be, again, I'll have to watch this and take notes because I'm coming up with all these ideas now. That could be an idea for a little small video as well. Let's have a look at like some sort of Irish exclusive stuff. We've got the GAA and hurling games. We've got like the 2FM version of like SingStar. Not that anyone gives a shit about SingStar, but yeah, I completely never knew that there was an Irish only version. And this has got an interesting sticker on it as well, because it's got the Euro and the punts. So at the time, I actually worked in retail at the time, that's how old I am. But yeah, just thinking back now, it was an absolute nightmare when we had like dual currency for the longest time. But I should look, we'll run out of another battery if we keep talking about stuff like that. Got a copy of Assault on the PS1 from Games World in Galway. Shout out Games World in Galway if you ever went there back in the day. We've got Spec Ops Covert Assault. I'm going to start playing through these actually because I don't want to lose the battery again because it's so close to the end of this. A copy of Star Wars Dark Forces. I don't know, again, it looks like, I know the PS1 games in the States are in these like jewel cases, but I'm not really seeing, is it like, does it have like an NTSC logo or something like that on the spine that makes them identifiable? I'm not really seeing it on those, so you'll have to let me know if you know what they are. Star Wars Episode 1 Jedi Power Battles. Civilization 2. Copy of Tiger Woods 99. I'm gonna have to, well, I don't know if I have room to move this, man. I'll have to at least straighten up this pile because we're gonna end up dropping a load of these in the ground. And me only mentioned how the cases are in nice condition, I'll end up smashing all the fucking thing. We've got Army Men Sarge's Heroes. Something is telling me I actually have this one already. Copy of Colin McRae Rally. Look at this, we have this like three times over now. A copy of Time Crisis. So this is fully complete, nice manual. It's the platinum version, but the disc is absolutely perfect on this. So I think I've got a complete one. I think one of the lads sent me a copy of it. We'll definitely put like a second nice copy together, maybe do a giveaway. We've got Tomorrow Never Dies. Oh, this is a class one that I had back in the day that I am delighted to have back now. And it's a copy of Gran Turismo 2. Gran Turismo games. I think anyone that had a PS1 back in the day had a Gran Turismo game. We've got World Rally Championship Arcade. This tower is getting perilously tall. We have Grudge Warriors. Again, don't know anything about that. We have, I'll tell you what, for the last little pile of games here, we're going to pull them out and get this box. We're not missing, oh, actually, there's one game at the bottom of this. I almost threw the box down with it in it, and I'm pretty sure this is a, I wouldn't call it a heavy, but this is not a cheap game. This is Alien Resurrection. Another one from Games World in Galway. I think this, let's just look at it very quickly. I know we're pushed for time, but really nice disc on it there. Anyway, we've got the manual and we've got the original cover art as well. Yeah, I'm gonna do a quick look up on this one on eBay, but I am pretty sure, not sure where I've seen it. I've seen it somewhere recently and I'm pretty sure this could be like a 40-50 euro game, which is absolutely bonkers. It's just sitting in this box randomly. I don't even know where the apps are on my phone. But yeah, let's have a look. Actually, hang on, we'll do a little screen recording here so you can see what I'm looking at. 3, 2, 1, let's go. Okay, so eBay, Alien Resurrection PS1. And we've got our souls on, okay. So this is selling from the States, complete in box, obviously in excellent condition with registration card for €165. That's bonkers, $68. Obviously, US prices can change dramatically. Alien Resurrection PS1 UK PAL, very good condition, high quality pack and first class, €116 from the UK. Now this is more like it now, €59.30 best offer accepted, sold for €53.32, sold for, well that's again, that's the States, This is crazy. So yeah, we're looking at possibly a 50 euro game. If anyone has an actual value on that, let me know, but that's bonkers. Not that it makes a difference anyway. We're gonna keep that. We're gonna put it into the collection, but crazy. Let's keep going through them. Jet Riders 2. We're gonna keep going. We're gonna get this tower completely stacked up without dropping any of them. Trust me. I know a thing or two about weight and balance for anyone that knows me personally, but Tunnel B1. A lot of these I've never even heard of, so we'll have to pop these in for a shot. Area 51. Oh, class, a copy of Tekken. Now, it's in a Disney's Tarzan box, but an OG Tekken disc there, so we'll have to keep an eye out for a case for that. Another one of these, like, oh, this is a PC game. Maybe they're all PC games, actually. This is Seven Kingdoms, whatever that's all about. We've got Tomb Raider Chronicles. This is another class one for the collection. Don't think there's a manual in here, but we do have the disc and the original cover art, so not bad for PS1. Coming across a few of these broken cases now, which that was to be expected. We've got a copy of Demolition Racer. And then last but not least is another Alien game. And this is Alien Trilogy. This is the platinum version of that. Nice heavy box. So we have got all the paperwork in there. We've got the disc and the manual. Yeah, so nice little way to end out that. But yeah, I don't even know what to say. Like, the amount of games that are here, like I said, we'll have to do like another little wrap-up stuff. But again, Jason, just want to say thanks so much for sending that in. That was great crack going through all that. We've got a lot of stuff that we're going to add to the collection, and we're definitely going to do some good with this stuff. Like I said, we're going to clean up the consoles. We're going to get them all tested out. If we can get them all working, I definitely think that we're going to maybe try and sell them off. Maybe we'll figure out a way to like do like a little paid draw or something like that. We'll take some money. We'll raise some money for charity, and we'll give it to a good cause, maybe closer to Christmas with that time of the year coming up soon. So again, thanks so much, mate. I had great fun going through all that, and can't wait to kind of sit down off camera now, start cataloging it, going through it. And like I said, we'll do some sort of like a little follow-up video where we kind of have like a good look at everything that's in here. But yeah, I'm conscious of the fact of how long this video has gone on for. So for now, I think we're going to leave the video there. I'm going to say thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed going through the unboxing as much as I enjoyed going through it here. Like I said, we'll do a little follow-up video fairly soon. Maybe we'll do some sort of a live or something. I keep promising that I'm going to do lives. I never have the feckin' time to do them, but we'll do some sort of follow-up video in some sort of format where we kind of have a look at everything that's all in here. We'll consolidate some of the discs and cases and stuff like that. And yeah, like I said, we'll do some testing out on consoles. We'll get them plugged in. We'll have a look for a few bonus discs and stuff like that. So that could be something fun to look forward to. So yeah, make sure you're subscribed to the channel to see what comes of all this stuff. But yeah, I need to properly get stuck in here now, go through all this stuff, just start organizing and getting a good idea what's in here. I'm gonna take a pretty fancy thumbnail for all this as well. We'll try and get it all, this is laid out fancy and looking good for that. And yeah, keep an eye out for the follow-up video. I know I mentioned about the Alien Resurrection there and value and stuff like that. Obviously value doesn't matter any of this stuff. Like, it was a very generous of them to send this into us here to unbox on the channel. And like I said, we'll get some nice stuff for the collection here. Hopefully you enjoyed the video of me going through it all, and hopefully we can do some good and raise some money for charity at the end of the year with the consoles and stuff like that. But thanks as always for checking the video out. Thanks for sticking this far, sticking to the end, and we'll see you again in the next one. Cheers. Let's just get the phone out. I was filming all along there. Shit. Copy of Star Wars Dark Force.